Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be discussing skincare. Everyone has requested, I shouldn't say everyone, a lot of people have requested to go over my everyday skincare routine. So I figured I would do it in two parts, do an AM one and then a PM one. It can get a little lengthy and I feel like it will just get really boring. So today we are gonna go over my AM skincare routine. Before I get into it, of course, take everything with a grain of salt. Not everyone is going to be a fan of the products that I like, and not everyone's skin is going to be a fan of the products that I like. These are the products that work well for me and work well with my skin. A little bit of a background, my skin is, I would say, kind of combination. I am more oily on my T-zone area, which is along my nose, a little bit of the cheek over here, on my forehead and by my chin. I am not really acne prone. I have semi-sensitive skin, not really, but with certain products, it can become a little bit more red and irritating. I never really had acne as a teenager. I do still get breakouts here and there, but I try to use products that kind of help combat that. If you do have any products that you really enjoy, just leave them in the comments below. I'm interested to see what you use and I'll try them. I'm not opposed to trying new products. I feel like I'm just one of those people that if the product works for me, I use it and I'm loyal to that product, to that brand. I am open to trying new products if they work well with my skin. So anyways, let's get into this video. P.S. This is my natural kind of curly skin. What am I even talking about? This is my natural curly hair. As I got older, I feel like it became more of like beachy waves. When I was younger, it was a lot curlier, but then also I was using a lot of gel to kind of induce those curls. I just use like a conditioner, kind of put some defrizzer on because it gets really frizzy. Let's get into this product review, or I should just say, go over my AM skincare routine. These are all the products that we will be discussing today. Got this cute little marble board from Home Goods. I put this on my countertop in my bathroom so I could kind of have all my skincare products accessible. In my bathroom, the mirrors don't actually have shelves in them, so everything is in cabinets below, and I just think it's really annoying to constantly go down and get skincare products. So I have this cute little marble tray to put all my skincare. On this tray is all my everyday products. Accessory stuff goes under in the cabinets. All right, so let's get into my skincare routine. So every morning when I wake up, the first thing that I do with my skin is I cleanse my skin. So I use, oh gosh, this lighting. So I use the Ject Gentle Cleanser in the morning. And I prefer something very calming and soothing in the morning, not too stripping, that doesn't dry out my skin. This cleanser is enhanced with vitamins A, C, and E. I just cleanse my skin in the morning. I kind of just use a small amount. Mainly I cleanse in my oily areas, which is along my nose and my chin area. So that's the cleanser that I use in the morning. Next, about two or three times a week, I will use these Ject AHA, BHA pads. And these pads are composed of 5% glycolic acid and 2% salicylic acid. Really, if you're trying to start using a chemical exfoliant, this is a great way to start because they're easy to incorporate in your skincare routine. They're just pads that you can kind of just swipe across your face. And essentially, what are glycolic and salicylic acids? So this combo helps unclog pores and induce cell turnover, which improves our skin clarity and texture. That being said, think of all of your BHAs. They get deeper into the pores and help kind of remove those dead skin cells and reduce the oil production. That's the salicylic acid. I really like that just because my pores on my nose and my chin are a little bit bigger and I do have more oily skin. So that really helps kind of maintain that skin balance and just kind of help reduce those pores for me. When it comes to using a chemical exfoliant, many patients, or I should say many individuals, haven't really started using one or incorporating them into their skincare routine. So this is just an easy way to start incorporating it. Another similar product are their Dr. Dennis Gross ones. I used to use those before using the Ject ones. Those are great as well if you want to order them from Sephora, or you can order these from the Ject website. I'll link all the products below as well. Let's kind of go back to the cleanser. I don't really have a favorite cleanser. This has been the cleanser that I've been using for a year and a half, and I've tried other cleansers and I just feel like they don't cleanse my skin. If you do have a cleanser that you really like, link it in the comments below. This is like kind of my go-to cleanser. I've tried other ones and I just don't really like them. Let's get into my third skincare product, and that is the Isdin Vitamin C little ampoules. So the Isdin Vitamin C ampoules comes in, or I should say the package looks like this, but these are the ampoules that are found inside. You'll see when I open it, mine's already used. They're all individually packed, which I really, really, really like. The vitamin C, as you may or may not know, as it's exposed to oxygen, it pretty much becomes oxidized and the color turns brown or orange. The way to know if your vitamin C is active, it should be pretty much a clear color like this, a clear yellow color. It should not be brown or orange. That means your vitamin C is no longer active. And why would you want to put an inactive vitamin C on your skin? Let's get into what vitamin C does. So pretty much vitamin C protects our skin from free radicals such as the sun or UV exposure. This particular vitamin C also has hyaluronic acid in it, which I really love because that really just moisturizes and hydrates my skin. After I cleanse my skin, a couple of times a week, I'll swipe the pads, and then I'll put a little amount on my hand of the vitamin C and I'll incorporate it, or I'll kind of just rub it into my skin, and that's my vitamin C. Next is my eye cream. So this is a sample because I ran out of my full bottle and I've been just using these little samples. I used to use the Neocutis Lumiere Illuminating Eye Cream. You will see that in my Instagram post. I recently switched over to the Lumiere Firm Reach Eye Cream. And what I like about this eye cream is that it literally does everything that you want. It improves the fine lines and wrinkles with the growth factors. It improves the firmness, the elasticity, and the texture of the under eye area with the actual peptides that it has in it. It hydrates the skin. It reduces puffiness with caffeine. It helps brighten the skin. Everything that you want in one eye cream instead of using a ton. I've also tried so many eye creams and I could never, ever, ever find a good one, but I really love this one. I love the texture of it. And this is the eye cream that I really actually see results with maintaining my under eye area and then just helping with fine lines and wrinkles. I don't have any other eye cream recommendations because I really don't love any eye cream. So if you do have any eye creams that you love, link them in the comments below. As well as with vitamin C, I used to use the SkinCeuticals C Ferulic, but I just felt like it oxidized too quickly on me. So that's the reason why I've been really loyal to the Isdin vitamin C. All right, next is the moisturizer. So this is my holy grail moisturizer. It is the La Roche-Posay Double Repair Face Moisturizer. I absolutely love this moisturizer, especially for every day. It's oil-free, it's lightweight, it contains niacinamide and ceramides in it. If you don't know what niacinamide and ceramides are and how they're beneficial, listen up. So niacinamide is vitamin B3, and what it does, it minimizes the appearance of pores, it reduces redness, it kind of improves and evens out your skin texture, and it increases the production of ceramides. And ceramides help strengthen the skin barrier and keeps it hydrated. Think about the ceramides as the glue, and it holds our skin cells together to keep it intact and keep that barrier intact. Especially someone like myself who is concerned with pores, this moisturizer is my favorite. It does not break me out. I love it. Michael loves it. I'm a fan. Other moisturizers that I really love are the CeraVe PM Facial Moisturizer. So not the AM, the PM I use as my AM moisturizer. And that's also oil-free and has ceramides in it as well. It's just really important to make sure your moisturizer is oil-free, or at least for me, just so it's not clogging your pores and breaking you out. That's a fave. If you have moisturizers that you like, link them in the comments below. Next, sunscreen. Oh, sunscreen. So SPF. So before we get into the difference between chemical and versus mineral, let's just say get a sunscreen that has at least SPF 30 and use it. But let's get into the differences. So I use a couple of different ones. So I have some that are just mineral, some that are a hybrid of chemical and mineral. I don't have any pure chemical sunscreens, but there are some, or I used to use just pure chemical sunscreens prior to that. Before we get into the different products, let's go over the difference. So with mineral sunscreen, you probably heard of zinc oxide or titanium dioxide. Those are the skincare ingredients that are found in mineral sunscreens. They are a physical sunscreen, so think of them as like they physically block the sun, so they don't let any UV rays penetrate into the skin. They pretty much sit on top of your skin and block those rays from the surface of the skin. They are more environment friendly. They are better for those who are more sensitive or acne prone. However, the downside is that many of them leave a white cast. So many patients just don't like using sunscreens or don't like using mineral sunscreens because they feel like they are thick. They leave that white cast and it doesn't sit well, just one under makeup. Or those who have darker skin tones, it leaves a white cast and that's not user friendly, essentially. That being said, let's go into chemical sunscreens. So usually you'll see the ingredients in chemical sunscreens, something that ends in benzoin. When you look at your sunscreen, you'll kind of know the difference if it's chemical or mineral based on the ingredients. How do chemical sunscreens work? So they use those chemicals to absorb the sun rays, churn them into heat, and then they release the heat through the actual skin. There have been some controversy that it's, you know, more harmful to the environment with chemical sunscreens. However, they are favored by a lot of patients just because they are sheer and they don't leave that white cast. The one thing I have to say is that mineral sunscreens, you know, you're immediately being blocked from the sun when you apply it. With chemical sunscreens, you typically have to wait at least 15 to 30 minutes before going out in the sun or before any UV exposure. Let's go into my three favorite sunscreens. There are so many sunscreens out there, but these are the three that work for me that don't irritate me. So first is the Elta MD UV Clear Broad Spectrum SPF 46. This is the hybrid one. This is the chemical and the mineral sunscreen. I use the UV Clear. They have a ton of different sunscreens. The UV Clear is just for patients like myself who have a little more of a sensitive skin, works well with me. And I use the tinted version. So if you see, when you put it on, it's tinted and it really just blends into the skin. Even if someone is not the same skin tone as that sunscreen, it really blends nicely into the skin. They also have a non-tinted version that I love as well, but I like the tinted version. Next is the Isdin Photo sunscreen, which is purely a mineral sunscreen. This is also tinted. So just so you have an idea of how it looks, I actually use this as just my makeup sometimes. It kind of helps even out my skin tone. They also have a non-tinted version of this sunscreen, and I can say that I use it on all my patients of all skin tones, and it does not leave a white cast. So this is a great chemical sunscreen to use. It also contains peptides and antioxidants, and they patent it with DNA repairsomes, which pretty much repair existing sun damage. Last is the Ject Everyday sunscreen. So this is a pure mineral sunscreen as well. This also doesn't leave a white cast on my skin. I like to use this as my everyday sunscreen, especially in the summertime, if you're more out and about. As you can see, when I rub it into my skin, it blends in really nice. Oops. And it's also oil-free, so it really won't clog your pores and it doesn't leave that white cast on your skin. There are a ton of sunscreens. Other ones that I like are the Isdin one, like I mentioned before, that's not the tinted version. Supergoop has great ones. They have an unseen chemical sunscreen that a lot of patients like just because you can't see that white cast. They also have mineral sunscreens, which I never tried, but if you have, let me know how you like it. CeraVe has moisturizer with the actual sunscreen in it. I'm never really a fan of a moisturizer and sunscreen together just because I kind of prefer my sunscreen and my moisturizer separated personally. La Roche-Posay has the double repair moisturizer with SPF 30. So if you're someone that just likes one step instead of two, then that may be an option for you. Essentially, just use your sunscreen no matter what it entails, whether it's chemical or mineral. I'm really happy when my patients tell me that they use a sunscreen. All right, so these are all my eight. Okay. That was a fail. This is my AM skincare routine. If you try these products and like them, let me know. If you try them and hate them, let me know as well. And if you have any products that you like or want me to try and review, let me know. I'd be open to doing that as well. Anyway, I'm going to end, oh Lord have mercy. I'm going to end this video here. I will do a PM skincare routine. Get ready for that one. I will link all these products in the description below. I also did a post on it on Instagram, so follow me if you don't already. Other than that, like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I'll see you all on my next video. Bye.